Imagine if the key to bouncing back from life's challenges was living right inside of you, not in your mind, but in your gut. What if the trillions of tiny bacteria in your digestive system were secretly influencing how well you handle stress? Recent research suggests that this might be more than just science fiction. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. We've known for a long time that what goes on in our guts affects our overall health, and I've talked in previous videos about the connection between the microbiome and mental health. But in this video, I'm focusing on newer research findings that show that how your gut bacteria affects how resilient you are. Let's review the basics. The gut microbiome is the community of trillions of organisms living in our digestive tract. These include bacteria, fungi, and viruses, but we'll mainly focus on bacteria today. Each of us has a unique microbial fingerprint shaped by factors like genetic, diet, and environment. Resilience is our ability to adapt to stressful situations, bounce back from adversity, and maintain our mental well-being in challenging times. It's not about avoiding stress altogether, that's impossible, but rather about how we respond to and recover from stressful events. Here's a little more about the gut-brain connection. This is a bi-directional communication system between our gut and our brain that works through several pathways. One is the vagus nerve, which is our longest cranial nerve. It serves as a direct line of communication between the bacteria in the gut and the brain. The immune system acts as another messenger, and various neurotransmitters produced in the gut also influence your brain function. So how exactly do gut bacteria influence our stress response? A 2024 study from the University of California, Los Angeles helps us understand the connection. The study analyzed the gut microbiome of 116 adults and found that the people who scored high for being psychologically resilient had less gut inflammation and less leaky gut issues. We already know that high levels of inflammation have been linked to depression and anxiety. Also, the bacteria in the highly resilient people produced chemical compounds that reduce inflammation. So their bacteria were pumping out anti-inflammatory compounds as part of their metabolism. One of these metabolites produced by the bacteria is the short-chain fatty acid butyrate. Butyrate is neuroprotective because it reduces inflammation and it also strengthens the gut barrier and influences the production of certain neurotransmitters like serotonin and GABA. So this is some important stuff that the good bacteria do to keep our brains and bodies healthy. And these contributions also help us recover from difficult situations. A healthy gut doesn't make us bulletproof, it just gives us more margin to be able to handle adversity and recover from it. So how do we keep our gut microbes happy and healthy? Well, it first starts with what we eat. Think of your gut like a bustling city. You want a diverse population of good citizens, right? A varied, fiber-rich diet is like rolling out the welcome mat for a wide range of beneficial bacteria. On the flip side, loading up on processed food and sugar is like inviting troublemakers to town. This can lead to an imbalanced gut community where the wrong types of bacteria take over. And these bad actors can stir up inflammation and even make your gut a bit leaky, which is definitely not what we want. The key is to feed the good guys and keep the troublemakers in check. So next time you're planning a meal, remember, you're not just feeding yourself, you're feeding the trillions of tiny residents in your gut. Lifestyle factors also play a role in increasing the good bacteria. Regular physical activity increases microbial diversity. Aim for at least 150 minutes of moderate intensity exercise per week. If you have health problems that limit your activity, consult with your doctor for ways to modify your exercise regimen. Chronic stress can negatively impact your gut health. Practices like meditation, deep breathing exercises, and yoga can help manage stress levels and potentially benefit our gut microbiome. Then there's getting adequate sleep. Poor sleep has been linked to changes in the gut microbiome. Aim for 7 to 9 hours of quality sleep each night. You also want to limit your antibiotic use. Yes, sometimes antibiotics are necessary to treat a bacterial infection, But not all infections are caused by bacteria. In fact, many are viral. So you don't want to be too quick to look to get an antibiotic every time you have an upper respiratory symptom, because antibiotics can kill off the good bacteria in your gut and change the constitution of your microbiome. If you need to take an antibiotic, you can follow up with other strategies to support your gut health. One approach is consuming probiotics and prebiotics. Probiotics are live beneficial bacteria, while prebiotics are the substances that feed these good bacteria. You can consume probiotics through fermented foods like yogurt, kombucha, and sauerkraut. You can also take probiotic supplements. You can consume prebiotics by eating foods high in fiber. This emerging research on the gut-brain axis and its impact on stress resilience gives us a broader understanding of how to approach stress-related disorders. It's important, though, to remember that true resilience comes from a holistic approach to mental health. And this includes not just taking care of our physical health, including our gut, but also developing healthy coping mechanisms, building strong social connections, and seeking professional help when needed. For more on the gut-brain connection, watch this video where I talk in more detail about probiotics and prebiotics. Thanks for watching today. See you next time.